All right, in this video, we're going to talk a little bit about creating content. So we're not going to get into all the specifics of the different content elements, but we've got about 12 or 13, I believe, different content types in the system. And that's kind of the Drupal terminology we'll use, content types. Every piece of content that you create, you can keep track of under this All Content link that's going to be off your homepage. Okay? Now, I've actually got a couple of pieces of content that I've put in here. Over time, obviously, as you input and create all these different elements, this queue will get fairly large. We've got the option, though, of sorting by the different content types. So over time, if you need to see a particular element, you have the option of going in and selecting a particular content type, applying the filter, and it'll bring up just those items in the system. Okay, let's go back to the home page here, and I do that by clicking on the view link. All right. So what I want to do is just do a quick example of creating a page and talk a little bit about the idea of every item that we create in the system is essentially a record in a gigantic database. So if I click on Create Page and I title this, and I'm just going to call this Test Page 1. Okay. And if I save this, note that what Drupal does with the URL is it takes test page 1, which is the title of this page, and it builds the URL from that. So it's taking test, which is the base URL for this group as I've set it up. It could be obviously slash English or slash registrar. In this case, it's test. And then it's taking the keywords from the page URL, from the page title, and it's building the URL from that. And it's doing that because we want descriptive terms that are in there, and that's going to help us with search. Okay, and so if I change this page title, this URL is going to change. And the other key thing, though, that what doesn't change, when I click on Edit, note that the URL up here switches. And what I'm seeing now is node 11351 edit. And it's basically saying I'm in edit mode, and this item in the system has a unique ID number that Drupal has created. And as we have hundreds of users in the system, these numbers will continue to grow. But this element in the system has a permanent marker of node 11351, regardless of whether I change that page title and the URL changes. So let's just demo that real quick. I'm going to change this to test page 1 for my office. Okay, and when I save that, let's see what happens to the URL. Okay, again, so that gets a little bit longer, test page 1, my office. And what Drupal is doing, again, for search reasons, it's dropping out prepositions, so it drops out the four, and it's going to drop out a, an, and the articles, which again are non-essential. And so so again, the take home on this is page titles affect URLs. If page titles change, URLs change, but your node ID for each individual piece of content in the system is permanent and never changes unless you delete that item from the system. Okay.